So welcome back to another episode, and today I'm going to talk all about NieR Automata and my experiences with the game. And I gotta say, I found online that people pronounce it NieR Automata, and I've been pronouncing it NieR Automata for so long that that's the title of the game to me forever. I can't change it, it's just the way it's going to be for me. So throughout the video, I think I'll refer to it as NieR, and this is a game by Square Enix, by Platinum Games, and we lost Scalebound, but we got NieR. I'm happy we got NieR. This is a very, very great game. And I'm gonna get all into the story and all of that. And first of all, I'm gonna put the game down and say, we are lucky to have a game like this because the first NieR came out and it was cool. I used to watch Pete Doerr stream this all the time and I became a regular watcher of his stream. So I ended up watching him play the entire game and it had a very emotional story, this first one. Great gameplay, but I never played it myself. It was a very big cult hit, but I wouldn't say it was a hit or a massive hit by any means. And then that was the end of NieR. So to get a spiritual successor, we'll call it, to NieR now on the PS4 is kind of like, really? We're gonna get this? What kind of gameplay is this? This is an action RPG in a semi-open world with some bullet hell shooter stuff going on in there. And I'm only gonna show footage that was shown in the demo, but this is the footage that I recorded from the main game. This is the entire beginning of the game. I don't wanna give a lot of spoilers. I will just mention the story and what happens at first in the story. This is just the setup, it's not later on in the story. Is that the world has been taken over by aliens using micro machines to invade the world, and mankind has retreated to the moon and is living on the moon, and mankind has sent all of these androids down to the earth to reclaim the earth. And it's a really cool setup for a story. I love that kinds of stuff. I used to love this old, you know, show. It used to be called Robotech, it used to be called Mospita in Japan, and the Invid came and chased mankind off the planet to Mars. It's reminding me of that kind of initial setup. It's kind of a lot of fun. But so you play as the android 2B, on the Earth, going around trying to solve the problems with these robots and finding out what's really going on and what the war is really about. And that's the basic storyline, and it's a lot of fun. It's interesting, but it's wacky. I have to say this before we go any further. This is a very Japanese game. There's some very unusual choices for it, some things that you'd only see out of Japan, including the musical score I want to talk about, is very unique, and I love it. It's so strange and different. I'm like, what the hell? This is the soundtrack? And I'm like, this is perfectly fitting. This makes total sense. But it's not what, if I was directing this game, I'd be going for a more traditional soundtrack at times, but Platinum came up with a choice to put some really unique music in that almost stands above the game in a lot of places. A lot of the times, I wasn't even looking at the visuals, I was just hearing the music and I was concentrating on that, and a soundtrack that I have to pick up in the future because it's really that good. How is the gameplay? Have you ever played a Platinum game before? You kind of know what the gameplay is about. It's action, it's over the top action, it's wonderful. You feel, Platinum has a way of making you feel, and they did this with Bayonetta, making you feel like you're an expert crazy player. And that's just in the way the aesthetics of the gameplay works, but it is really up to the player. You can do a lot of combination attacks, you can, you know, upgrade your character in all sorts of different ways, get different items, get different weapons, but the execution of your combat techniques is so much fun. And then you have this device that follows you around, that shoots all the time, and it feels like you're always in a shoot-em-up video game of the old past, and it's a really good combination of some, you know, 2D side view stuff and some overhead and some shmup stuff and some 3D action stuff. There's a lot going on in here and there's a lot to really appreciate, and that's one thing I'm gonna say right now is that I really appreciate that they made this game. This game is a massive gamble that you don't see anymore. I saw more gambles like this on the PS2 when I think game design and game creation was a little bit cheaper, where now, where it takes a lot of money, a lot more money than they did back then, There's a lot more writing on a game, and I think this is a big gamble for Square and for Platinum. And I think they've come together and pulled it off incredibly well, and I'd be nothing but blown away by this game. I've had a really, really good time. Now, what is the world like that you're exploring? Now, I'm coming off Horizon Zero Dawn and Zelda Breath of the Wild. We're not looking at an open world like that, but we're looking at an open world that's open enough that it doesn't feel small. There's a lot to do, and that's something else to say about the open world, is there's a lot of different people and like tribes and stuff like that within this world, and headquarters and bases set up that you can talk to people, go on quests, upgrade your equipment, and you buy a lot of your equipment, and there's also like save places throughout the open world that you can save at any time. There's creatures in our in this world, which is the Earth, a devastated Earth. In the future, there's a lot of wildlife walking around, and you can ride the wildlife at times, and you can do power slides on them. This game is over the top, crazy, wacky, weird, but it's so much fun to do combat in this game, and some of the boss encounters I've seen, and I don't want to ruin anything, they've been so creative and so Platinum and so interesting, and you're doing at least three different things within the game. When you're fighting a boss, you're, you know, avoiding bullet hell shooter, shots at yourself while attacking an enemy, attacking maybe a sub-boss of that main boss. So there's a lot going on in the gameplay, and it's always a lot of fun. Now, I'm playing this game on the PlayStation Pro. To me, these graphics look awesome. I'm not disappointed at all. Sometimes I think one of the negative things I can say is sometimes the open world feels like there's not a lot going on out there. There's stuff all over the place, but it feels very barren at times when you're traversing around. But I'm telling you, the frame rates are beautiful. There's a little bit of pop-up once in a while, but nothing to be too concerned about. The animation of the characters, the animation of the enemies is really great. The shading, the textures. I really like the graphical look. I think it works really well for this game. And there's been a lot of moments where I just stopped and looked at the graphics and was like, wow, this is beautiful. They've done a really fantastic job. So, and NieR Automata comes with another feature that I wish every game had, and that is a reversible cover. I just like having the option to do that and, you know, being able to switch from the US cover to the Japanese version or the European version. I just think it's a great idea that they included that. Yeah, it's getting a big recommendation from me. I'm really happy, no pun intended for the frickin' show here, but I'm really happy that NieR Automata got created and I'm playing it right now and I'm having a great amount of fun. And it's really a hard act to follow when you're coming after Horizon Zero Dawn and Zelda and Nioh. This game just fits in that perfect combo. It's really, we're back on track with NieR, and I really recommend it if you like Japanese games, action RPGs. You're starving for a Platinum game? My God, you're going to love this game. You really are. The story starts to open up and take us in some really wacky directions that is fascinating and interesting at the same time. It's what I call a really good science fiction story that is, you know, just absolutely wacky at the same time, but very well executed and a lot of fun, and nothing but wonderful things to say about NieR. So anyways, guys, until next time.